Man, the NFL is a brutal business. Cutthroat. One season, you're riding high, on top of the world, everything is clicking for you. The next season, you're on the chopping block. Your team's looking to trade you, draft your replacement, whatever the case may be. Now, as a quarterback in the NFL, you're playing for your job every season. Unless your name is Tom Brady, Drew Brees, who just retired, unless you're one of a handful of guys, you're playing for your job every year. Look at Aaron Rodgers in Green Bay. Super Bowl winner, numerous NFC championship games, league MVP. Aaron Rodgers has accomplished all you can accomplish at the NFL level. The Packers still drafted his eventual replacement just last year. Franchises in the NFL care about one thing and one thing only. Winning. As a quarterback, if you can't win consistently, you're gone. It's as simple as that. Even if you do win consistently and you get older like Aaron Rodgers is getting, you could still be gone. Hell, it happened to Brett Favre. Brett Favre took the Packers to the NFC Championship. I believe they were even 13-3 that season. And the Packers let him walk that all season so they could go ahead and go with Aaron Rodgers. Those are both quarterbacks that have a pedigree, a history of winning, an established legacy. When you're a quarterback like Jimmy Garoppolo, you don't have that luxury. Instead of having a history of winning, Jimmy Garoppolo is more known for his extensive history with injuries. Jimmy G's been in San Francisco since 2017. He has missed more games due to injury than he's actually played in and started. Back in 2019, Jimmy G is riding high, led the Niners to 13-3 that year, made it to the Super Bowl. And that almost seems like a decade ago now. That's how quickly careers can die in the NFL. I'm sure there are some people out there that have even forgotten that Jimmy Garoppolo even played in the Super Bowl. He was roundly criticized for his performance in that game, which I didn't think was fair. Jimmy Garoppolo wasn't what I would call great in the Super Bowl by any stretch, but he damn sure wasn't bad. Actually, he had San Francisco in a position to win. He had the Niners up 10 points in the second half. It was the defense that fell apart in crunch time. And also, Kyle Shanahan got real conservative with his play calling, trying to run out the clock. That was a team effort loss. It wasn't all on Jimmy Garoppolo. Though he still shouldered most of the blame for it anyway. That's one of the things that you have to put up with when you're a quarterback in the NFL and you don't have a pedigree, a legacy already established. Another situation you have to deal with is the situation that Jimmy G is finding himself in right now. John Lynch and Kyle Shanahan pulled off a trade last week with the Dolphins, securing themselves the number 3 pick in the draft. NFL teams don't give up the amount of draft picks that the Niners gave up to move up that high in the draft to pick anything but a quarterback. John Lynch didn't move up that high to draft a running back. He moved up that high because they have serious concerns about Jimmy Garoppolo's future. Kyle Shanahan made their intentions clear while he and John Lynch spoke to the media on Monday. Here's what Kyle Shanahan said, quote, "We're in a situation where when you bring in a rookie quarterback, to me it's always better, especially on the team that you have. If you've got a veteran starter there already who you like and you're comfortable winning with, that's usually the direction you want to go and not throw someone else out into the fire until they're fully ready. That's the situation we're at. It's going to be hard to find a quarterback who gives us a better chance to win than Jimmy right now," end quote. Another example of Coach Speak 101. This is Kyle Shanahan trying to save face with Jimmy Garoppolo. "No one gives us a better chance to win than Jimmy right now." Key words in that statement? Right now. The Niners need Jimmy G right now. And he's not stupid. He knows exactly what's going on here. Shanahan admitted that Jimmy G was pissed off when they moved up to get the number 3 pick in the draft. He was also pissed off that they were trying to trade him. So Shanahan is trying to build up his confidence publicly, make him feel like he's really wanted in San Francisco. But the Niners' real plan is to have Jimmy G mold this rookie quarterback that they draft, show him the ropes a little bit, teach him the offense. That way, when the time comes for him to replace Jimmy Garoppolo, he'll be ready. And then they'll just throw Jimmy G away. Thanks for your service. Now get the hell out of here. That is standard operating procedure in the NFL. We have seen this same story countless times before. And look, I'm not knocking John Lynch or Kyle Shanahan for the decisions that they're making. It's the right call. They're just doing their jobs. Their job is to put the San Francisco 49ers in the best position to win football games. They find themselves in a situation where their franchise quarterback has essentially missed two of the last 3 years. So from their standpoint, you can't risk putting all your chips in the Jimmy G basket. You just can't do it. I mean, it makes perfect sense for them to do what they're doing. You have to have a backup plan. But we're also looking at this from Jimmy G's perspective. What does any of this benefit him? It doesn't. It's to his detriment. Jimmy Garoppolo is entering the most important season of his NFL career, and it's also likely to be the most difficult season of his career to this point. The Niners are loaded. They have an elite defense who's going to be well-rested since most of their key players missed last season due to injury. They have weapons offensively, great coaching staff. The Niners have all the ingredients to make a Super Bowl run. The pressure is going to be on Jimmy Garoppolo to lead them there once again. All the while, his replacement is going to be standing on the sidelines, waiting in the wings, so to speak. If Jimmy G has a bad game, the media questions will be relentless. Are you considering benching Jimmy G for Mac Jones or whoever the Niners draft? Jimmy G's about to find himself in the same predicament Alex Smith was in a few years ago in Kansas City. Andy Reid had Patrick Mahomes just waiting to take over. Alex Smith had the Chiefs in the playoffs every year. His final year in Kansas City, they made the playoffs. Andy Reid still went with Patrick Mahomes the following year. Obviously, that was the right decision. But it's going to be the same type of scenario in San Francisco. The same thing happened last year in Miami, too, with Ryan Fitzpatrick. He was the better option for that team at quarterback. They had a playoff caliber defense. They were in playoff contention. And Brian Flores goes with Tua instead, which knocks Miami right out of the playoffs. That's how it goes in the NFL. When a team drafts a quarterback in the first round, sometimes even in the second round, it's not long before the rookie becomes the starter. That shiny new car looks much more appealing than the rusted Dodge Dart. Even if Jimmy Garoppolo leads the Niners to the playoffs this season, it is not going to be enough to keep him around in San Francisco long term. The Niners owe Jimmy G nothing at this point. All the guaranteed money has been paid out on his contract. They can release him at any time. Kyle Shanahan made a comment on Monday that even if they draft a quarterback, he is really pulling for Jimmy Garoppolo to succeed. Now, I'm just not buying that. I'm not buying it. I don't care what John Lynch and Kyle Shanahan say publicly. They can build Jimmy G up to be the next Peyton Manning publicly. But their actions on how they really feel about him say otherwise. They're moving up to number 3 in the draft because they don't have faith in Jimmy Garoppolo. Plus, whoever they draft at number 3 is coming in way cheaper than what they're currently paying Jimmy Garoppolo, which sets the Niners up, if that rookie quarterback can handle it, it sets the Niners up to win for the next few years. Instead of spending $25, $30 million on their quarterback, they're spending $1 million, $2 million, maybe even less than that. And they can use the rest of their money to make the roster stronger. You look at many Super Bowl winners, not all of them, but a lot of Super Bowl winners. And you look at their recipe for success. Cheap young quarterback, spend money on a strong defense and skill positions on offense. That recipe was when the Seahawks were the most successful. It's how the Chiefs won their Super Bowl too with Patrick Mahomes. The reason I said a second ago that this was the most important season of Jimmy G's career is because his performance this year is going to determine his future in the NFL. Not his future in San Francisco. That Titanic has sunk. I'm talking about his future for his next team in the NFL. This could be Jimmy G's last chance to prove himself as a starter in this league. I know he made it to a Super Bowl. Doesn't matter. I know he was banged up with injuries last year. Doesn't matter. If he has another season like he had last year, he's done as a starter in the NFL for the foreseeable future. His stock would drop dramatically across the league. The way other teams will look at it, if you can't win with the talent that they have in San Francisco and you're healthy, then where the hell can you win? This isn't like Sam Darnold with the Jets, where he's playing with nothing but scrubs. Teams will give Sam Darnold a second look. If Jimmy Garoppolo can't win this season, or even worse, if he can't stay healthy, then the only job that he'll be getting in 2022 is a backup position somewhere. Now, one thing's for certain. He won't be the starter for the San Francisco 49ers in 2022. Now, what do you guys think? Am I wrong? Am I wrong about 2021 being Jimmy G's final season in San Francisco? And if that's the case, if you think I'm wrong, then who will the Niners draft at number 3? Let me know in the comments below. Make sure to like and subscribe. Click the notification bell to receive all notifications from the channel. Best way to contact me is by email at btlkc84@gmail.com. KC_BTL84 on Twitter. I'll see you guys tomorrow.